Flag was going to come down Vancouver's commercial drive, but because of protesters, the flag and the torch were not able to come down commercial drive. Well, the reason I didn't find the protesters is because they were moving with the torch, I guess, today. So they're following the torch, and they boxed them in down at Hastings and Canby today. They boxed in the torch. Final leg of the 2010 torch relay in Vancouver was halted Friday morning by a massive gathering of protesters in Hastings Street. Hundreds of Olympic critics holding signs proclaiming homes not games banded together near Victory Square at 9:30, temporarily blocking the torchbearer and procession. After a short delay, organizers rerouted the relay around the protest, and the torch continued down Hastings at 9:35. Lauren Gill, one of the protest organizers from the ironically named 2010 Welcoming Committee, said that there was no significant altercations between protesters and police. "I'd say that there were 40 or so police officers on motorcycles, horses, and on foot," Gill said. "But there were
out of the games, dozens of Olympic athletes fail drug tests. Banned for doping.
More than 30 athletes.
A surprise twist as heavy fog hangs over Whistler and a skier is rushed to hospital. But Olympic fever can't be dampened on this, the eve of the opening ceremony to Vancouver 2010. Tomorrow night, with billions of people watching all around the globe, Canada will make a major statement about this country's relationship with its Aboriginal people. They have been a part of the planning with Vancouver organizers right from the beginning, part of an unprecedented partnership. CTV's Tom Kennedy has the story.
As the Olympic flame made its way across the country, as important as all those urban centers was this. The flame visited more than 100 native communities, and with reason. Aboriginal peoples have been asked and have accepted to become equal partners in these Olympic Games.
The 2010 Games are really not the end, but the beginning of a relationship that is going to be more open in dialogue with each other.
It's never been done before. The Olympic movement now considers British Columbia chiefs as heads of state. The Olympic medals are an expression of Aboriginal art. There are nearly $60 million of Olympic contracts for Aboriginal workers and merchandise. An Indigenous culture from Canada and overseas at the heart of the city.
We were receiving more exposure in these games than ever before in the history of this country.
It is not without controversy. In some communities there have been anti-Olympic demonstrations, but generally, Aboriginal participation and enthusiasm usually hold unprecedented.